Hi everybody, it's Tish show at TishsDishs. Or you could say Letitia too, whatever. So I got this. It's a hot roll mix, cinnamon rolls, and it's you could do pizza or two. So I looked at the expiration date and it's still fine. They just needed to move product and I got it for $1. So it's still good. There's nothing wrong with it. So we are going to make cinnamon rolls. So let's open it. On, baby. Let's open it. Take out the package. Here it is. And oh, starter yeast. Okay, so what we're gonna do, so the directions say that it needs a cup. Let's do the wet mixture first. So it needs a cup of warm water. It says 180 so that you don't kill the yeast. That's the key thing is you don't wanna kill the yeast. It said two, that's not hot, two tablespoons of butter. Okay, let's put that on there. I'm gonna put inside, I'm gonna make a cinnamon mixture. So it wants to make the cinnamon dough sweet, but my husband has diabetes. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna put a tablespoon of sugar. That's all I wanna put in there. And then I'm gonna put one egg. And I have these on. These are my beaters for bread. So let's beat this up and then we'll put the yeast in. Okay. Let's see how this goes. Okay. That's done. Put that there. Let's put the yeast in. And you know why they, you should have the reason I put the sugar in because yeast usually needs some help to rise and sugar is its friend. So there we go, yeast. There, let's beat this up again. Okay. Now, oh, I don't know why I put those over there. Okay, now let's put in the mixture. This is the flour mixture. You can see it. Oops, there we go. Let's pour it in. There we go. And then once we do this, we're just gonna let it sit on the. We'll put some. Well, what I'll do is, well, just watch me. Okay. And I need to put the oven at 350. 375. Okay. Okay, I'm probably going to have to finish the rest of my hands. Okay, let's put this here. Okay, let's do it with my hands. Okay, we just want to mix it around, get all the dough off the sides. Put this here. My cutting board. Okay. We slap it. Bad boy, bad boy. No, just kidding. Okay, let's do this. Let me get some okay. And I'm gonna let it rise for a little bit. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna start on. I'm going to clean everything up and then we're going to use the same bowl and we're going to make the inside ingredients for the rolls. Okay. So rolls. Okay. So on this recipe, it says to put in, we're going to put in a cup of brown sugar. I'm going to put all the dry stuff first. It says to put in some cinnamon. So it says a tablespoon and a half of cinnamon, which is a lot, I think. It says to put in a third of a cup flour. Okay, put that there. Let's mix this up. I'm not going to use my blender because I don't want it to like splash all over the place. Let's just mix it all together. So let's do this. Let's put in, I'm going to use half butter and half olive oil. So I don't want it too buttery. I don't want it to overpower. Middle of a whisker. Okay. And then shake it. That's probably about 2 tablespoons, I would think. So let's whisk it up. Ooh, look how it looks. So it's supposed to be like a little pasty mix. See? Turn it into a paste. See? Okay, so this is done. And okay, so just dump this in there. So as I'm rolling out the dough, this does not get like cookie on me. So let's put that. Let's cut this out. Let's do it like that. Let's let this sit too. Sit right there with my dough. Okay, so now get started. So we're gonna make like caramel sauce that I decided we're gonna do sticky buns. So what I'm gonna do first is I am going to spray my pan, even though it's a nonstick pan. I just wanna make sure that my cinnamon buns don't stick to the side. Okay, so that's done. So what I'm gonna do is I have a cup of brown sugar. And hold on a second, I got to get some. And I, you know what, I ran out of, my fault. I ran out of butter, but it needs an oil. So I'm gonna try this, it should be okay. So I'm gonna put 6 tablespoons of olive oil. Let's try something different, what the heck. 1, 6. So it needs an oil, because it needs to have something that's gushy. I am going to put in, a teaspoon of vanilla. I love vanilla, so I don't care how much it goes in there. So I put in brown sugar. Oh, you know what I need? I need some heavy cream. Okay, so we need about 3 tablespoons of heavy cream. So 1, 2, 3. So what it's doing, it's gonna be a caramel sauce. So what we wanna do is we wanna put it on meat, low. We don't want this to boil. We just want it to just be enough to where it is all mixed together. And then we're going to put it in our little saucepan. So you probably could see what I'm doing, hopefully. So it's going to make a caramel. So we want to make it to where it disintegrates into a sauce. We don't want it to boil. We want it to be thick and delicious. If you like, you can add a little bit of cream in there. You know what? And I might just do that. There you go. And use heavy cream. So we're making a caramel for it. So we don't want it to boil. We just want it to like cook to make it all nice and juicy. And once we get it to where it's nice and juicy, we're gonna put it in our pan. And then I have over here, I have some chopped. It'll be fine. Cool it up. Yeah, it looks good. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to dump it in my pan like this. Come on. Come down to play. See how it came out? So with that mixture that, I'm going to put there. So that mixture that we, see? I don't know if you can see it. I think you can see it. So what I am going to do is I am going to, where should we put it? Okay, so what I'm going to do is I am going to sprinkle the nuts in here like this, see? There we go. So this is gonna go right here. This is done. So we're gonna put it right here. And next we're gonna do the dough. It's doubled in size, so it's ready to rock and roll. Okay, it's ready to rock and roll. Okay, so let's get on to the dough next, guys. Okay, TishsDishs, subscribe. Okay, everybody. Now, see how much it rose while making the caramel sauce with the nuts? You know, here's my mixture. You could actually have rolled it. We're going to roll it out. So what I'm going to do is I am going to push on it. I don't want to mess with it now. See, just push it, push it. Come on, push this. Now let's roll it. Okay, very lightly. Okay, so I think we're okay with it. Okay. Then, this is that mixture we made. So let's get it. Let's open it. Let's fluff it on there. Okay. Now, this is interesting. Wow, it smells really good. Let's just see how we can move it all around. All day, guys. Okay. I think this looks fine. Okay, so now, make sure I always put a clean one all the time. So, okay, so let's roll it. Okay. Don't let it like get too thin. Just roll. Let's roll. Come on, baby. Don't stick. Don't stick, please. Please don't stick. What I did is, usually you'll put some flour on this, but I didn't because I don't want it to be like doughy. No dough for me. No dough dough. Okay, so here's my pan with all my juicy, delicious stuff in there. Then I got thread. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the middle. Come on, let's see. Okay, let's go to the middle of the dough. Well, it should be doing that, but oh, that's okay. Okay, so we're at the middle of the dough. So I'm just going to cut. I want to cut this in half. Okay, so let's cut. There we go. So then I'm going to put this through it again and cut this in half. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to stick that in there. And one. Stick that in there. Two. Okay. I should put them close together. I'll fix them when I get to that point. So see and watch. See how it cuts it? Just perfectly. So it doesn't squeeze it. Okay, come on. Oh, this one didn't want to cut. I love this thing. I love it. Okay, one more. Okay, we're to the final part. Then we'll just space them around and then so that they have enough food to puff up. Okay. Let's cut it. If we have, there we go. Put that there in the middle. Let's put this over here. Put that over. Okay. Let's squish them down a little bit. And what I did is I put my oven at squish, 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 squish. Pat it, pat it, pat it, pat it, pat, 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 pat. Okay, so I set my oven at 375. I'm going to put this in there for no more than 20 minutes. I'm going to pull it out and let it rest for at least 10 minutes. And then I'll show you what happens after. I'll flip it over and all the gooey stuff will come out. So let's put this in the oven, 20 minutes. And then once it's done, you'll see what I do next to TishsDishs cinnamon rolls. So, and okay, it's done. So I'm going to sit that there. And I'm going to set it there for at least, give it like 5 to 10 minutes. It's up to you on how you want it. I'm probably going to let it sit for at least maybe 5 minutes because you don't want it to stick to this pan. So we're going to flip it into this pan here. So let's let it cool down. I'm going to set my timer for 5 minutes. Be back to show you what I'm going to do next. Very interesting. I don't want to burn my hands. I've got to do it. Okay, this. think this is big enough. Yeah. Okay. Okay. My God, a dog is barking. Okay. Really good. Oh wow. This looks good. Tastes really good. So I'm gonna let it sit. Okay, this is what it looks like. My sticky buns. It depends on how much nuts you like, but I guess sometimes you feel like a nut. Sometimes you don't. I like nuts. Nuts. It's got a lot. So okay guys. We're gonna look good. So tomorrow we're gonna try one, okay? See my okay. Tish's. Okay, let's taste it. What I did is I took a piece off, I put it in the microwave so it warms it up, and I'm going to take a taste of it. This is really good. Oh my God. This is good. This is really good. One more bite. Oh, this is super duper good. And the nuts. This works. I got it for $1. $1. $1. $1. It was in the dollar basket, or they have like the dollar baskets and they have different things. So I looked through. And the only reason they were getting rid of this, and I should have bought more, is that they needed to turn products. So always just look at the expiration date or the use date, but also the expiration date. But they're not expired. Why not buy them? I mean, it's like $1. Made me a sticky bun. My husband says they're called monkey buns, but really good. So if you follow the directions of the back, you'll make this. Make mine. Sticky bun. I've always been a bargain shopper. I learned from my grandma that there's nothing wrong with it. Saving money on food is the number one issue for me because everything's getting so expensive. And so we find go to that basket wherever it's at and whatever grocery's at and whatever grocery store you go to and look in there and you'll find things. I mean, you'll find some great things. So just remember. Got it from the dollar basket, and it works. So, ciao. Peace out. Bye, guys. Okay.